Hey, what's going on out there? I'm Sean Devine. Hope you all are doing well. In this tutorial, I'm excited to share with you all the all-new Ozone 10 Advanced from Isotope. We're going to take a look at the new modules, which include the stabilizer, which will dynamically match a frequency curve of a reference, or they have measured the top songs across genres. We also have a new impact module, which can control expansion and compression in terms of multiband. So you can really dial in transients and dynamics across your spectrum there in your master. We also have improvements to existing modules like Imager. There's an all new recover sides mode for those of you who need some help with your mono compatibility. And there's also a great new soft clipper in the maximizer section. Not to mention, Master Assistant has been completely overhauled and improved. You can match not only tonal balance of a reference, but also loudness, imaging, dynamics. It can really target those and get you very, very close. This is not just a suggestion anymore. We're going to master a track from scratch here today with the new Ozone 10 Advanced. Let's take a listen to my mix. This is Keha Uptown Saturday Night. It's produced by Bach Beats. And then we'll get started.
Music's loud, full moon. We just trying to catch a good time like Nico Moon. Now that big got me persuaded, so glad that I made it. Talking to a pretty little thing, I'm upgrading. She had me locked in when I saw her tonight. Man, it's funny the things that happen on a Saturday night.
On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night. She had a pretty little face with a little bitty waist. Damn right, she can call my eye.
All right, so that gives you an idea of the track, and I feel like this is a good example because this song has a lot of different genres kind of mashed in, so we can see, you know, how intelligent Ozone 10 actually is in terms of the curves that it selects, because this thing has country, rock, hip-hop, you know, pop, all kind of mashed into one. We're going to click the Master Assistant view up here, which is this tab here, and when we click that, it's going to say waiting for audio. And what we need to do is just go ahead and select the loudest part of our track. It's going to measure about 8 seconds to build this suggestion. So let's just go here where the hook starts.
Uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night. She had a pretty little face with a little bitty waist. Damn right, she can call my eye. On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night. She had a big old boat. Side to side,
come on. That foot is going up, down, side to side. Her foot is going up, down, side to side. Come on.
Now we in the truck, headed back to my place. Slow down, baby girl, you know it ain't a race. Woo! She looked at me and said she wanna have fun.
So in about 10 seconds there, we already have a pretty professional sounding master from my mix. So first we can see what target it selected. And in this case, it went ahead and said, okay, well, this most closely matches rock. So we're going to use that for the EQ, the stabilizer, the width, and the dynamics, right? If we wanted to, we could select a different curve. So let's say, you know, Ozone didn't really optimize that quite the way we wanted to. We could go ahead and just select hip hop and rap, right? So let's select that one. You'll see we get a very different curve.
Uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night. She had a pretty little face with a little bitty waist. Damn right, she can call me. On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night. She had a big old booty going round and round.
So obviously with the hip hop curve, you know, we get more bass, more low end, and not quite as bright a top end, as the rock is going to have more of that accentuated low mid, and the highs are going to be a little bit brighter. So again, you can go through and select which is going to be best, but in my experience, you know, it does select the best curve more times than not. In the previous versions with Master Assistant, it would kind of give you that suggestion, and if you wanted to go in and get your hands dirty, make some adjustments, you would have to go in here and, you know, start tweaking the modules yourself. You've got some convenient controls here in Ozone 10 to immediately make adjustments here from the assistant view. So for example, if we are matching that EQ curve that of the target that it gives us, we can then scale that. So if we wanted to, you know, kind of bring that back.
She looked at me and said she wanna have fun. We skipped first base and hit a home run. Now she steady calls me honey and spending all my money, but I'm okay with it because I'm getting so yummy. Never thought so, but it feels so.
You know, we can adjust the strength of that EQ correction accordingly. Same thing with the stabilizer. We're gonna talk more about this in depth, but just know that this is dynamically matching our frequency response to the target curve. Does some really interesting things in terms of dynamics. It's also saved my butt already in mastering, because I've had some mixes come to me that have had certain parts of the song that were just not very consistent. So for instance, the hook might be a little bit too loud in terms of the vocals, but then the verses felt a little better. The stabilizer will just give you a little bit of glue, and in that way, I found that to be really useful. But if you have a pretty balanced mix, in my opinion, less is more with this stabilizer, so we can turn that back a little bit. Now, you're going to notice that we now have width match as well, so it's going to match that stereo field to some of these songs that they measured. And again, you can scale that accordingly.
She looked at me and said she wanna have fun. We skipped first base and hit a home run. Now she steady calls me honey and spending all my money, but I'm okay with it cause I'm getting so yummy. Never thought something would feel so right, but it's funny the things that...
Same with the impact module there. And then we also have the maximizer adjustment. So if we want to increase the loudness or decrease, you know, how much it's pushing that maximizer, we can do so there. Just a note with the targets, you see all our genres there, but some of you are going to say, well, I don't see my preferred genre or the genre that you work with. Typically, you can always use your own target. So in this case, I have another song that I mastered for this artist. Let's say we were working on an album and I wanted to kind of match that. Now this song, different style, but if I select that, it will then build the chain and build that target based on the reference file. So you can utilize whatever you want there, and it will have that target there for you in this graph. We're going to go ahead and stick with this rock target that they have set for us, and I'm going to switch to the detailed view. And let's go ahead and talk about the new stabilizer module, which is arguably the biggest addition in terms of new modules. We have two modes. So the default is the shape mode. And what this is going to do is it's going to have an adaptive EQ boost and cut across our master to match the tonal balance target, right? So depending on where we set that amount, you're going to be able to visually see those boosts and cuts happening. So let's just go here.
They got me persuaded, so glad that I made it. Talking to a pretty little thing, I'm upgrading. She had me locked in when I saw her tonight. Man, it's funny the things that happen on a Saturday night. On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night. She had a pretty little face with a little bitty waist. Damn right, she can call my...
So in terms of the actual effect of this, I found it's just really helpful in giving you some glue and, again, giving you some stabilization of the dynamics, making sure that everything is consistent throughout the mix. And depending upon the balance of your mix, you know, some mixes are balanced better than others, at least the ones that I get for mastering. And so a little bit of this stabilizer can go a long way in terms of giving you that consistency. Now, the other mode is a cut mode, and all this will do is just cut to tame some harshness and resonance. So if we turn that on, you're going to see all it's doing is reducing those resonance bumps here.
She looked at me and said she want to have fun. We skipped first base and hit a home run. Now she said he called me honey and spending all my money, but I'm okay with it because I'm getting so yummy.
If you're curious about what's going on, you can select this delta button. So this is going to monitor what is actually being attenuated in the case of cut. And if you select shape, we can actually monitor what is being cut as well as boosted to match that curve. So let's go ahead and take a listen to what that's doing.
She looked at me and said she wanna have fun. We skip first base and hit a home run. That she said he called me honey and spending all my money, but I'm...
So it's taming some of the low end, some extreme lows there, as well as some of those resonances, but that delta button just makes it easier to know what you're doing. One thing I have noticed with the stabilizer is that if you have the amount up and you get a little bit heavy with it, it can kind of have a bit of a pumping effect throughout the song, depending on if you have like a quieter section, something like that. But if you want to, you know, smooth that out beyond just adjusting the amount, we can go down to speed, and you can either speed that response up or slow it down in terms of how it's stabilizing. We also have a smoothing control. So if we adjust that, it's gonna give us a smoother stabilizing effect.
Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night. She had a big old boat going round and round. Up, down, side to side.
For a track like this with a big low end, I could hear that it's obviously cutting some of that extreme low and the sub, but maybe I don't want that to happen, especially if, you know, a hip hop bass heavy mix, I don't really want it to stabilize as much. So we have controls here for lows, mids, and highs. And let's just say I didn't want that to happen. I could just turn the low stabilization all the way down and then just keep the mids up as well as the highs. So it'll just control those. Finally, there is a tame transient. So if we've got some spikes in terms of our dynamics, that'll just kind of tighten things up here.
Slow down, baby girl, you know it ain't a race. Woo! She looked at me and said she wanna have fun. We skipped first base and hit a home run. Now she steady calls me honey and spending all my money, but I'm okay with it cause I'm getting so yummy. Never thought so.
Not my preference for this particular song, but again, can be useful to tame some of those spikes. So moving over to the impact module, we didn't really have a multi-band transient adjustment tool, and this is exactly what that is. So if we go down here, we're going to see crossover points for, you know, lows, low mids, high mids, and highs, and then we can solo those. So if we go up above zero, that is going to function as an expander, and it's going to really give us more punch and some sharpness to the transients in that part of our frequency spectrum. Now, if we go below zero, that's going to provide compression or glue. We also have a master amount slider here that will scale the effect of the impact module for all the bands.
My place. Slow down, baby girl, you know.
So when I hit that delta button, once again, as with the stabilizer, we're hearing the difference or what is actually being added by the impact module. All right, so let's talk about a new update to the imager module, and that is this recover sides feature. So a lot of you out there have questions on the channel about maximizing mono compatibility. You know, if you adjust your imaging and reduce width, you want to make sure that you still retain the same power, the same presence and impact in mono. So it can be a little bit tricky when you're on your stereo width controls, and let's say maybe you have some correlation problems, you're trying to fix that in the master. But when you reduce some of these bands in your master, you're actually losing some of that information. So what Recover Sides will do is it will actually add that information back to the mono signal so that we keep that depth and power. This will only become active if we reduce any of these bands in width. So let's just say we took out a little bit of low width below about 125, and then we reduced some of the top end and we solo it. So again, depending on how much you reduce the width of any of these bands, you'll hear that side information that's then being recovered and then put back into the signal. So let's unsolo that and I'll turn it off and on.
She looked at me and said she wanna have fun. We skipped first base and hit a home run. Now she said he called me honey and spending all my money, but I'm okay with it cause I'm getting so yummy. Never thought so, but it feels so right. But it's funny the things that happen on a Saturday night.
On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night, she had a pretty little face.
So it might sound a little bit subtle there, but going to be very useful in terms of maintaining as much depth and power in our master as possible when we are reducing width, and especially if you're dealing with a mix that has some more inherent phase correlation issues. For those of you who follow the channel, you know that the Ozone Maximizer is one of my favorite maximizers out there. A lot of flexibility, some great IRC modes here, which, matter of fact, I'm going to switch this to transient because that is my personal favorite here in Ozone. Just gives you a little bit more punch and some better dynamics there if you have heavy drums. But now we have a cool new soft clip mode. Now, I know some of you know what soft clipping is, but the effect of this is that it's going to give you a bit more of a lift, some saturation in your master, and just some thickness, if you will. So let me just go ahead and play this back, and I will slowly bring up the soft clip so you can hear what happens.
She looked at me and said she wanna have fun. We skip first base and hit a home run. Now she steady calls me honey and spending all my money. But I'm okay with it cause I'm getting so yummy. Never thought so would feel so right. But it's funny the things that happen on a Saturday night. She looked at me and said she wanna have fun. We skip first base and hit a home run. Now she steady calls me honey and spending all my money. But I'm okay with it cause I'm getting so yummy. Never thought so would feel so right. But it's funny the things that happen on a Saturday night.
On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night, she had a pretty little face with a little bitty waist. Damn right.
We can select light, medium, or we can go hard if we want to really do some heavy soft clipping there. I've been utilizing this in my own masters, and it's just a welcome addition that really takes things over the top in terms of the Maximizer module. All right, so now that we've looked at the new modules and some of the new additions here, tried out the Master Assistant, I'm going to go back and just make some subtle adjustments here, just using my ears as a mastering engineer, just to kind of get this dialed in the way I want it, and then we're going to listen back.
She looked at me and said she wanna have fun. We skip first base and hit a home run. Now she steady calls me honey and spending all my money. But I'm okay with it cause I'm getting so yummy. Never thought so would feel so right. But it's funny the things that happen on a Saturday night.
On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night, she had a pretty little face with a little bitty waist. Damn right she caught my eye. On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night, she had a big old booty going round and round, up, down, side to side. Come on! Take it off, man!
On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night, pretty little face with a little bitty waist, damn right she caught my eye.
On an uptown.
All right, so I'm going to turn on game match now, and we're going to bypass it, and then I'll engage it, and we can hear what Ozone 10 did for our mastering.
She looked at me and said she want to have fun. We skip first base and hit a home run. Now she steady calls me honey and spending all my money. But I'm okay with it because I'm getting so yummy. Never thought so would feel so right. But it's funny the things that happen on a Saturday night.
On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night, she had a pretty little face with a little bitty waist. Damn right. On an uptown Saturday night, on an uptown Saturday night, she had a big old booty going round and round, up, down, side to side.
All right, y'all. So with that, we have checked out the all new Master Assistant here in Ozone 10 Advanced, as well as the new modules, Stabilizer, Impact. Crazy improvements to the Imager and the Maximizer, and we're just touching the surface. There are some other new things under the hood here with Ozone 10 Advanced. Comparing this to some of the previous versions, you know, I felt like the Master Assistant was a great kind of starting point, at least as a suggestion, but now I feel like with these customization and scale features and the Stabilizer, as well as matching width and dynamics, the updated curves, as well as the ability to target a reference, this gets you a lot closer than, say, Ozone 9's Master Assistant, and then gives you a lot more control. Whether you are a beginner trying to get your mixes to sound more professional, have a professional master to go out so that your music can be heard in the best light possible, or you're a seasoned professional mastering engineer, Ozone 10 Advanced is going to be a welcome update for you. But let me know what you think about it. Are you going to be picking this up? Let us know in the comments below. If you have any questions about what we did here in Ozone 10 Advanced, feel free to leave that as well. If you learned anything in the video, please like, subscribe, and consider sharing. Hit that notification bell for more. We'll talk to you soon.